This video takes another look at molecular polarity, determining whether or not a molecule is polar or not. But this method only works, it's only valid, if it's one of the simple molecules that we typically do in Chem143. That is, there's one central atom and no more than four electron groups in the central atom. You cannot apply this method if there's more than four electron groups, which we don't see in really in Chem143, but there it is. So, there's two possibilities. Either the outer atoms are all the same as each other, or they're not. There's going to be one central atom almost all the time for us, and the outer atoms. Now, you can usually tell by looking at them at the formula if that, you know, if they're the same or not. For instance, carbon tetrafluoride has four fluorines attached to the carbon. Carbon central, four fluorines attached to it. They're all the same as each other. Here, there's a carbon with two bromines and two fluorines. They're not the same. So those are examples of the two cases. So first of all, if the outer atoms are not the same as each other, then for the molecules that we deal with, the simple ones that I mentioned a minute ago, you know that the molecule will be polar if at least one of those bonds is polar, period. That means a difference in electronegativity bigger than 0.4. Now, no matter whether the outer atoms are the same as each other or not, if there are no polar bonds, then the molecule is not polar, period. That's all you have to do. So let's look at these two molecules here. Now, there's here carbon central. There's two hydrogens and two fluorines, so the outer atoms are not the same as each other. And so the carbon-hydrogen bond will not be polar because 2.5 minus 2.1 is 0.4. That's not polar. But the fluorine-carbon bond will be polar. 4.0 minus 2.5 is 1.5. And again, because the outer atoms are not the same as each other, and only because that's true, and because there's at least one polar bond, that's all we have to do. This is a polar molecule. We can stop there. This molecule over here, it's a good example, but it's a little bit beyond the scope of this course in some instances. It ends up that the nitrogen is the central atom, even though typically we put the least electronegative central, the bromine. It ends up nitrogen central. And there's two chlorines and one bromine attached to the nitrogen. Now, so the outer atoms are not the same as each other, but the bromine-nitrogen bond has a difference in electronegativity of 0.2, not a polar bond. And the chlorine-nitrogen bond is also non-polar. They have the same electronegativities. And that means that this is a non-polar molecule. So if the outer atoms are not the same as each other, if you can find at least one polar bond, then you know the molecule's polar. If you cannot find at least one polar bond, then no matter what, it's a non-polar molecule. Now, if the outer atoms are the same as each other, then two conditions have to be true for the molecule to be polar. Again, for the simple molecules that we deal with in this course. The first condition is the bonds, they're all going to be the same type of bond because it's all the same type element attached to the central atom. The bonds have to be polar, difference in electronegativity bigger than 0.4, and the molecular geometry has to be one of the two non-symmetric shapes that we saw. We saw three symmetric shapes, linear, trigonal, planar, and tetrahedral. We saw two less symmetric shapes, bent and trigonal pyramidal. If the bonds are polar and the molecular geometry is either bent or trigonal pyramidal, then we can say that the molecule is polar. For example, in ammonia here, the outer atoms, hydrogens, are all the same as each other. The difference in electronegativity is 3.0 for the nitrogen minus 2.1 for the hydrogens is 0.9, so the bonds are polar. And when you draw the Lewis structure, it looks like this. The central atom has 1, 2, 3, 4 electron groups, one lone pair, it's trigonal pyramidal. So both of these conditions are met, this is a polar molecule. Carbon tetrafluoride, the outer atoms are the same as each other. The difference in electronegativity is 1.5, 4.0 for fluorine, 2.5 for carbon. But when we draw the Lewis structure, we have four electron groups on the central atom, zero lone pairs. The molecular geometry is tetrahedral. It's not one of these two. So this is a non-polar molecule.